To begin with, Mr. Speaker, we need to be grateful that we have today an opposition responsible enough not to even question the credibility of the Statistical Service that had provided a lot of these figures today. That actually is a positive departure from what we used to have in the past. Mr. Speaker, I've heard the Finance Minister speak eloquently about the very competent manner in which he and his team have managed the economy. Let me congratulate him, and also to tell him to hasten slowly. When he reaches a moment where inflation has gone down into single digits and kept there for a period of 3 years, he can come for some boasting. Yeah. When he reaches a moment when he's able to grow the economy of Ghana to at least 14%, he can come for some praises. When he's able to reach a moment when he's able to take treasury bills down to below 10%, to about 9%, he can count for some praises. Until then, it's important for the Minister of Finance to hasten very slowly, because he has not achieved anything yet. Mr. Speaker, I also overheard the Minister say that he inherited a very weak economy. That's always very debatable. Because Mr. Speaker would have thought that if somebody inherited an economy at the time when the gross reserves of the country stood at 1.8 months of cover, and then you are inheriting 2.8 months of cover, you clearly cannot be talking about a weak economy, because what you left behind at the time actually was almost in a state of comatose. But we didn't make that kind of comment. Mr. Speaker, if somebody met 18% inflation in 2009, and you are meeting inflation that is 15.4, declining downward, you obviously know that you are inheriting a much better economy than what somebody inherited before you. Yes. Yes. Mr. Speaker, if somebody dealt with interest rates, treasury bill rate of up 25% in 2009, and you actually met that 16%, and for you to be talking about a weak economy, you obviously are not being very truthful. So, Mr. Speaker, it's important for some of these facts to be stated clearly in order for us to be able to have a very good debate. But, Mr. Speaker, bottom line has to do with the fact that the major things that you promised to the people of Ghana, nothing has been heard so far. Cost of living to the people of Ghana, that's the most important. What is really being happening to it? Nothing much. You talk about free SHS. And as of now, we have a situation where you are literally running away from the very thing you spoke about. Continuing students are totally being left in the lurch. And you are now talking about some few students who will actually qualify to inherit their free SHS. That's not true. Mr. Speaker,
well done.
Talking about jobs. We should be talking about a situation where the people of Ghana can be talking positively about jobs. But really, for all that you've spoken about declining, indicators that are getting better and better, the job for the young people of Ghana today is not available. They cannot even be talking with any hope about jobs. So it's important for us to hasten very slowly in order to be able to know exactly where this country is going. And the final thing, Mr. Speaker, I will say is this, that for all that the minister has boasted about, the revenue performance clearly showed that we did not really see any creativity by way of revenue policies. Otherwise, he should not be talking about missing revenue targets today, and we now talking about exactly the same problem that we used to have in the past. So, Mr. Minister, it's important to hasten slowly, because the journey is very long, and the reality will soon dawn. Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Yeah.